Hello friends, I'm here with another session of class 12th English, and today I'm going to discuss another chapter, that is Deep Water by William O. Douglas. This is an excerpt taken from Of Men and Mountains. In this chapter, the writer has used an autobiographical element to discuss the fear of water. In the story, the writer mentions his own fear of water. Although it is an extract taken from his book, but after studying this chapter, we can get an insight to understand about fear. Because fear is an emotion, those who must have studied psychology, they are very well aware of this fact that fear is one of the emotions. And this fear, we all are affected by this emotion one or the other way. In our life, there are so many situations when we suffer from fear, and that fear can be of any kind, because of some tragedy, because of some mishappening, or even when we are worried about the future. But here in this story, William describes that when he was a young boy, and at that time he had that fear of water. The reason was because in his life he faced such situations, and because of some incidents, or I should say misadventure, that took place in his life, he got stuck with this emotion of fear. When the story begins, William O. Douglas, he describes that at the time he was just of 10 or 11 years ago, and at the time he thought of learning swimming. He decided that he should learn how to swim. For that purpose, he chose the swimming pool, that was YMCA. That was the most suitable place to learn swimming. He bought new water wings so that he can go there and learn how to swim. When this small boy went to the swimming pool, what he observed, that so many children, they all were enjoying in that swimming pool. Slowly and slowly, this boy, William, he observed that how other children were enjoying in the water. He copied them. But when he was there near the swimming pool, some old memories that pop up in his mind, because in his past he had some incident that took place in his life, and that was just marked in his mind somewhere. That incident was in his subconscious mind, and when he again faced that water in the swimming pool, old memories again came in front of his eyes. He described that another incident. When he was just 4 or 5 years old, he went with his father to the beach of California. Here, when he was on the beach, what happened? The waves, they knocked him. He was all covered with water, and he was just a small child of 5 or 6 years. You can imagine, if such incident takes place in the life of a small child, how he will react. Yes, his heart was full of fear. His father was aware that no harm was there for the child. He laughed. But the small child, he faced that situation and he was scared. That small incident was somewhere in his subconscious mind. And today again, when he was near the water in the swimming pool, sea memories were revolving in his mind. But slowly and slowly, he was trying to learn to swim. Then one day, what happened? When he reached the swimming pool, he was all alone. So he thought of just to wait, let the other children come, and then he will start his swimming. He was just sitting. A big boy of 18 years, he came there. He saw that small boy. He said, "Oh, skinny." Why he said skinny? Because this small child was not that much of very good in physique. He was slim. And when this boy noticed that small child, what he did? He picked William and he threw him deep in the water. And here we can get connected with the title of the story, that is Deep Water. This boy was now in the water. And while he was going down, although he was frightened, but still he planned a strategy. He thought that as soon as he will reach, he will touch the bottom, then he will make a jump and he will come out like a cock. He tried, but what happened? The thing was totally opposite. He came up very slowly. Water was all around him. Then again, he tried for the second time. While he was going down again, he tried to make a jump and come on the surface level. But again, because he was a small boy, although he put his energy to come out of the water, but he could not. And again, he started sinking deep inside the water. And then the situation came when it was a complete silence all around. Peace prevailed because now this small boy was drowning. He was going to the state of dying. He tried to hold something, but no rope. He tried to call someone for help, but nothing happened, and slowly he was in a drowsing state. Then, when he came back to his consciousness, he found that he was lying on the surface and he was just in a state where he was vomiting. Although he was saved and the boy was next to him, he said, "Oh, I was just fooling. I didn't know that something this is going to happen." And on the other side, someone said that this little boy was almost drowned. But with God's grace, he was saved. And from that day, the fear of water, which was somewhere in his subconscious mind, it was now in a big form. Because so many things happened in his life, one after the other. Although he tried, but still, now that fear of water was on a permanent mark somewhere inside his subconscious mind. And then he started avoiding water, going to such places. No swimming, no boating, no enjoyment, no fishing. And in this way, many years passed away. And then he heard of the waters of Cascades. Somewhere inside his mind, inside his heart, he wanted to learn swimming. He wanted to enjoy all that which he had left many years back. Then he thought that he should learn proper method of swimming. he went to some instructor so that he can guide him that how he can learn swimming. From that day, he started his lessons of swimming. And in this way, he tried to overcome the fear of water that was deep inside in his heart. The trainer was excellent. He told him many methods. By applying those methods, he can learn how to swim. And this process started with a proper method. What the trainer did? He tied a rope around him and it was attached with some pulley. So in this way, the trainer told him to swim inside the water. This was the first level to learn how to swim in the water. In the next step, he told him that how to exhale and inhale inside the water. Because for swimming, it is must that one should have a complete control over one's breath. Then he learned the art, then how to breathe inside the water. After that, the trainer also guided him that how to have the movements of legs, how to utilize those different strokes which are required in swimming. Backstroke, front stroke, all were taught to that little William by the trainer. And when he learned all the methods of swimming, then the trainer told him, "Now, my child, you are ready to swim." And then he experimented. He tried to swim in the water and he did that. But still, somewhere in his mind, he was not satisfied. He thought that what if I am all alone in the water? Would I be able to face that challenge? He again tried this step. He went all alone. And then he said to his own fear, "Terror, you want to make me scared?" In a way, after learning, after getting a proper training, now he was capable of facing his own fear. Time passed away. And then he thought that if there's still some kind of a small point is still left, am I still nervous or now I am capable to swim anywhere for many hours? For this thing, he went to Lake Wentworth. And when he was swimming there, he crossed the shore, he again came back to the shore. And in this way, he conquered his own fear. "Terror, you can't make me scared anymore." These were the words that he said to his own terror, own fear of water. So friends, in this story, you have observed from the very beginning and till the end how William was able to conquer his own fear. With his strong determination and willpower, not just strong determination and willpower, plus one more thing is added, and that was his hard work. Because of his hard work and strong determination, the small boy William was able to conquer his own fear. So in this story, deep water. I hope now you all are well aware that how this term is connected with William Douglas. Deep water inside. And that deep level, there is one level of water. that is mentioned, he went inside and how he tried to overcome, that is fine. But as I told you earlier, every story has two levels. One is subtle level and the other is surface level. Surface level, as I explained you, the summary of the story. And when we'll think about the subtle level, that is the deeper level. And that deep level is inside us. That level is within each of us. But the need is to have that faith in yourself, to have that strong determination as well as strong willpower, so that you can face all the challenges of your life. And if you want to be successful in your life, then failures are the stepping stones to your success. Because it is well said that Rome was not built in a day. And one more thing, where there is will, there is a way. So, this is the important theme of this chapter, Deep Water. I hope that after watching this video, you will try to find out that are you people suffering from one or the other kind of fear of something? And if it is there, then you should try hard to achieve, to conquer your own fear of whatever kind it is inside your heart, in your subconscious mind. And if you will try hard, then definitely you are going to succeed in your life. This is all for today's session. Thank you so much. Please like and subscribe. Also, press the bell icon. Thank you so much.